Back here at home, wear the mask. It's a plea from a father of four who is now a single parent after his wife passed away from COVID-19 complications. His life has changed both emotionally and logistically as he takes on more responsibility. The 9 Team's Jaffney Gray has his story and ways others can cope after a devastating loss.
Here one day she was gone the next, you know. This ain't no joke. People think it's fun and games until it hit home, man. It could happen to anybody.
Andres Garcia's life has changed forever.
He just turned around for the worst and I lost her.
His wife, Erica Garcia, was one of eight COVID-19 related deaths Mayor Ron Nirenberg announced Sunday. She was diabetic and she just turned 41 on June 22nd.
I still can't believe it myself. We all miss her.
Erica leaves behind her husband, four children, and so many who loved her.
You know, she helped anybody out that she could, and, you know, it's hard, man.
It's something that no one ever plans for or wants to happen. No one can predict this, and it is traumatic. A lot of things change with this.
Political psychologist Dr. Lindsay Bira says the changes includes the reality of life after losing someone. For Garcia, who is now a single parent.
That was my rock. She was my foundation, man. I lost my best friend.
He has to learn a new routine.
She took care of the bills. She made sure bills got paid. She made sure there was food.
Bira says families awaiting outcomes from severe hospitalized COVID-19 patients should prepare for worst case scenario.
Start the education process. Get the ball rolling of what happens next so that it's not completely overwhelming.
She might have left me physically, but she's by my side. She's by my side spiritually, her life.
If you are in a situation similar to Garcia's, Dr. Bira says, do not be afraid to ask for help. If you like to help someone who just recently lost a loved one, Bira says you can help by reducing stress. You can fix them meals, or you could just check in on them to make sure they're doing okay. Jaffney Gray, KSAT 12 News.